Hello and welcome to this evening's editions of Weird World Disorders. I'm Dr. Tim.
And I'm Dr. Ella.
And tonight we will be discussing the rare condition that is Cotard syndrome. The syndrome was named after Dr. Jules Cotard, who first described the syndrome in 1880. Cotard syndrome is a rare disorder defined as having nihilistic delusions concerning one's own body or existence as a whole. These delusions are often seen as mood-related delusions of a depressive episode with psychotic features, namely participating in behavior that is unhealthy for the body because the body or parts of the body have been deemed to no longer exist or function. The disease is one that cannot be diagnosed without a verbal expression of nihilistic delusions. In other words, no one can administer a test that reads the patient's thoughts and determines they are not convinced that they are alive or their organs are not functioning. A review of 100 case studies concludes that Cotard syndrome can exist in three stages, the first stage being the germination stage, where the symptoms of psychotic depression and hypochondria appear, the second stage being the blooming stage, the full development of the syndrome and delusions of negation, and third, the chronic stage, which is continued and severe delusions and chronic psychiatric depression. So the research and literature behind the cause of this disease are scarce and not fully understood. Some of these suggested underlying causes are agitated melancholy, depression, anxiety, guilt, delusions of mortality, bipolar or schizophrenia, dementia, cognitive deficits from a neurologic disease, such as Parkinson's or brain tumors, traumatic brain injury, and intravenous malformations. Nihilistic delusions are typically a symptom of an underlying disorder. Many times a patient will experience a severe manic episode before the nihilistic delusions. No difference was found between men and women or between underlying diagnostic categories. Age seemed to increase the likelihood of developing nihilistic delusions. Depression was reported in 89% of subjects. The most common nihilistic delusions concerned the body, resulting in 86%, and existence of 69%. Anxiety at 65% and guilt at 63% were also common, followed by hypochondriacal delusions 58% of the time and delusions of immortality with 55%. One of the more common underlying conditions is bipolar disorder. Bipolar disorder and other mood disorders seem to be associated with an imbalance in brain chemicals known as neurotransmitters, specifically serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. An imbalance in hormone levels may also be present in people with bipolar disorder. Depression is included as a major underlying cause of Cotard syndrome. Neurotransmitters are brain chemicals that likely play a role in depression. While these chemicals are out of balance, it may be associated with depressive symptoms. Changes in the body's balance of hormones may be involved in causing or triggering depression. Traumatic events such as the death or loss of a loved one, financial problems, high stress, or childhood trauma may trigger depression in some people. People with depression appear to have physical changes in their brains. The more recent invention of brain scanning has revealed many interesting characteristics and abnormalities in the brains of patients suffering from Cotard syndrome, bringing us one step closer to being able to determine a definite cause of the syndrome. The first PET scan of a person with Cotard syndrome revealed their metabolic activity in the frontal and parietal regions of the brain was so low as to resemble someone in a vegetative state.
Cotard syndrome is often associated with the median, frontal, lobe, and parietal lobe lesions. Neural misfiring in the area of the brain, which normally aids in recognizing faces and associates emotions to a recognized face, are believed to be one cause. Left untreated, it can cause brain atrophy, which is the brain shrinking. This is irreversible damage and can spread throughout the brain if left untreated. Electroconvulsive shock treatments can be given to restart the blood flow and stop the cells from dying further. A patient was diagnosed with kidney failure and was found to have a high serum concentration, which is the main metabolite of the drug acyclovir, was found in cases of Cotard syndrome, and even with the reduced dose of acyclovir, it didn't go away. The hemodialysis, Cotard syndrome, did decease and hemostasis was achieved. Studies were found that brain atrophy is common in the stroke victims with left-sided weakness, motor skills on the left side, sensitivity to pain, cold, touch, vibration, and difficulty with positioning the left side of the body. These symptoms are typical of such a large right hemisphere lesion. This in turn causes the nihilistic behavior commonly found with Cotard's patients. For a chemical balance, the antipsychotic drug therapy was successful in the delusions. Most common in Cotard syndrome patients is some form of temporal atrophy, mostly in the left side, or hyperfusion, which is lack of blood flow through an organ, in the anterior temporal lobes, more so than the posterior. You will find this with Alzheimer's patients, as well as stroke victims. It affects speech or irregular words, recognition of faces, nihilistic delusions. There isn't anything to balance the damaged atrophy part of the brain. Risperidone can be given to curb the delusions of Cotard syndrome, and the antipsychotic drugs are given for the secondary etiology of Cotard syndrome to return the balance of neurotransmitters that control the chemicals in our brains. There are cases of severe migraines and seizures that have caused irreparable damage to the cortex, the thin layer of gray matter covering each hemisphere of the brain, which is responsible for memory, perception, thoughts, and forming languages. This all leads to neurotransmitters that are responsible for chemical balance that affect a person from not recognizing their own image, surface dyslexia, to speaking clearly or recognizing their own form. All of these patients, as well as dementia patients, bipolar patients, and schizophrenic, are all treated with antipsychotic therapy to rebalance back the homeostatic change in their brain and to their bodies.
The one concrete tool for diagnosis in this syndrome is the person has to be experiencing nihilistic delusions. With Cotard syndrome being a syndrome rather than a specific disease, it leaves the use of diagnostic tools for the underlying cause in a broad category. The tools used to narrow down a diagnosis are as follows. A mini mental state examination, which is a 30-point questionnaire test that is used to screen for cognitive impairment. It is commonly used in medicine to screen for dementia. The NCSC, the Neurobehavioral Cognitive State Examination, which is a cognitive screening test that assesses 5 cognitive ability areas: language, construction, memory, calculations, and reasoning. Magnetic resonance imaging is a test that uses magnetic fields and pulses of radio wave energy to take pictures of the brain. In many cases, MRI gives information that can be seen on X-ray, ultrasound, or scan. The MRI can also show tissue damage or disease, such as infection or inflammation, or a tumor, stroke, or seizure. In some cases, a dye may be used during the MRI to show pictures of structures more clearly. Computer tomography can be used to examine blood vessels in the brain. This procedure is able to detect narrowing of blood vessels. Positron emission tomography, or PET, is used to measure metabolic activity in the brain. Or SPECT, which is single photon emission computerized tomography. Instead of just taking a picture of anatomical structures in the brain, a SPECT scan monitors levels of biological activity at each place in the 3D image. The image can show amounts of blood flow in the capillaries of the imaged area. Without further research, there is a general limitation for systematic studies lies on the fact that there is a lack of clinical instruments or diagnostic criteria for the measurement of Cotard syndrome. So at this point, it is based mainly on skilled psychiatric interview. Which leads us to our next point. Because exact etiologic agents are not fully known or understood, treatment should follow a thorough diagnostic workup of the underlying disorders. Various psychotropic medications and electroconvulsive therapy, or ECT, has shown results in a number of patients. Others have reported success with either single pharmacologic agents, such as antidepressants, or antidepressants paired with mood stabilizers, such as haloperidol, risperidone, or lithium carbonate. Routine monitoring of patients on these medications is necessary due to side effects generally including, but not limited to, swelling of the tongue, mouth, or lips, hives, drowsiness, nausea, vomiting, increased suicidal or depressive thoughts, or confusion and slurred speech. Now we will take a look at a portrayal of Mademoiselle X, one of Dr. Cotard's first patients, and the way this disorder affected her life.
I am so tired. My stomach has rotted away. Who are these people? Why haven't I crossed over yet? Cremate me immediately. I have no stomach. Who are these people?
I am dead.
My time on Earth has ended.
I am so tired.
They keep telling me to eat. Dead people don't eat.
Don't eat.
You have to eat or you will die.
I don't know why people keep telling me this. I have no stomach. I'm not alive. I'm already dead.
My time on Earth has ended.
I don't know who you are. Why do you keep bothering me? Get away from me!
Cotard syndrome is mostly found in people who have other underlying issues like severe or manic depression, bipolar disorder, Alzheimer's patients, dementia, and schizophrenia. There are many other disorders, but these are the most common. Only the symptoms, disorders, or diseases can be treated to alleviate the emotional symptoms that go with them. The patients will be on antipsychotics for life to treat many other afflictions that one needs to function. However, these people don't usually find themselves living in the workforce like a healthy individual would. While the nihilistic delusions go away for most, there are some people who have no symptoms of anything else but will have Cotard syndrome. The findings are that if underlying conditions are the cause of Cotard syndrome, response to treatments are poor, and so is life, as some die from starvation or organ failure.
Thank you for joining us on this evening's edition of Weird World Disorders. Until next time.
Join me dance, dance, dance.